I'm gonna make some heat tonight.
Okay.
Tom Cruise.
The reason I don't do all that yelling is if I talk quietly, you really gonna have to listen to what I'm talking about. All that yelling shit is out. If I talk like this, nigga, you ain't got no choice but to hear what the fuck I'm saying, nigga.
So hard to spit out when I'm facing you. How much you wanna know what kind of war you trying to take it to? Hard to stop this shit when we start fighting. This ain't pay-per-view. Fucked up, that's a fact.
Like I do, love you like I do.
I feel like this part, like this is the catchiest part, you know what I'm saying? That's big. I think it could be like bigger.
Like beat-wise or vocal-wise.
Like if she layered those like I do, yeah. Like I love when it goes up to that, and I think she could say love you like I do every time. Not just the like I do, yeah. Or whatever.
I feel like if she sat down with Jay too and he did some of his harmonies, because he's hella good at those stack harmonies,
right.
It'll really bring it to life. Like, yeah.
Right. Let's have him like just lay that, like even if it's just to hold the place of the idea. So obviously, we need your blessing to do this, but I think this could be very tight.
Okay.
Yeah.
You heard of a song called First Love?
You ever heard it?
You heard that one?
I love that that would be what she would sample if you did.
I just hope we didn't do it any disservice.
We haven't even heard it yet, but they've been working on it, and I'm excited.
We just did this in the other room, but we don't see.
I'm mad the bigs ain't up. So what happened? They got blew
the tweeters.
Up?
He blew out the tweeters last night, I guess.
So we're getting all the high end off the diners and the sub. So it's like,
I think they blew out the big speakers yesterday. So you only getting the low end out of the big speakers and the high end is coming out of the
I mean, it's knocking though.
Thinking about my first one.
It should go straight to
the hook.
Yeah.
Oh.
It should be intro. Verse 12 bars. So intro is just the like her song, the guitar, and then goes to verse 12 bars, first one, and then in the hook, like reperforming with like a couple of exchanges, and then straight
to
into the next verse.
And then the bridge.
Not the guitar coming back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Don't bring the guitar back besides the intro. It doesn't leave any room. And then the second verse, 12 bars.
In that bridge.
To the hook, and then bridge. Yeah.
No, okay. I think after the second verse, it should go straight to that bridge, cause it's already kind of like that. Did
before,
you fuck with that?
Before it goes to the hook?
Before it goes to the hook.
They know Icy Gerald. You knew Hyvie Gerald. Buzz was my apparel. Yeah, that was high school Gerald. AC Spencer Gerald.
Just like a fairy tale is how we begun. How much with the magical moments turn to memories.
Oh, no. Okay, look.
Oh, different part.
Okay,
back. Y'all so the last line, say back when we
you just
young.
Isolated it from
me. Yeah. Magical moments turn to memories.
Okay, let me do it a couple more times.
What is it?
What's
the fourth line right now?
Can you talk more about time, Dad?
Absolutely. It boils down to what's our goal as a society.
Yeah.
What do we want people to be able to do when they get back? From prison, right. Serving their time. I would argue, not the people here, would argue that we want people to be able to work, be able to provide for family, be able to be connected, and be coaches for their little league sports team, which they cannot.
And these are all things you can't do.
These are all things that you cannot do right now. And to me, that's setting people up for failure. And,
you know, to go up against a system that's created this vicious cycle, it's like it takes that kind of like systematic change to end this cyclical like nature of it. And it's really, I mean, what resonates with me, and at least, you know, from like theoretically, from like a when you step back and you look at it like from a broad spectrum, it's like taking money out of prisons to reduce prison population and putting it into, you know, organizations like this right here, Larkin, that's trying to help kids before you find yourself in this position in the first place. You know what I mean? And really just providing you know, providing places of love instead of hate, you know what I mean, literally. And to know that you're not the only one and you have support and you have other people just like you.
How you doing? What's up, bro? You been good?
Yeah,
I'm talking about. You know my cousin Reese? Mm-hmm. I know my cousin, that's what I'm talking about.
These two are the leaders. No party in New York is considered a success unless they are there. It's hard to explain this young lady and man. They say they don't want to be explained.
The backwood guts in the stew.
Empty bottles.
Bro, I hate that, bro. Don't.
Or just a packet of a backwood.
Like, bro, that
shit. Like, you always know where to find Jake because you just follow the trail of them.
Look, it's a trail.
Disgusting.
There is a trail.
We're gearing up into spring and summertime. Let's have something that's really bright. Let's have something that celebrates the season. It's been a long winter. It's been a long, like, 2018. So let's brighten up all of that with a drink that sort of combines lots of flavor elements all together, but still highlighting the spirit itself.
Yeah, I think they're all incredible. Really, really interesting drinks. The first one, very aesthetically pleasing. The color story around it, the whole concept, the vibe, the feeling it gives you of summer, the place it takes you. We're sitting in under fluorescent lights in a conference room, but I feel like I'm in Hawaii. I feel like I'm on vacation in Mexico or something. You know, it tells that story. And when you look at it, from the garnishes to the colors, from the pink to the green to the everything, it gives you that vibe. It's a little too bitter for my taste, but it's beautiful. The second one, the whole story around the maple and the creativity behind that really just stood out to me. I mean, it's even the pepper finish. I turned 30 in 2 months and it made me feel like I'm growing up. It was definitely a bonito. And the last one is just, I mean, so classic and the crushability level, I should have wrote a 10. Yeah, it was just incredible.
It's really hard to pick between the three because they're all just fantastic. This is the toughest round.
Is there a drum roll? I'll turn it over to Gerald to announce the winner.
And the Grammys, the Academy Award goes to the Tiger Woods of Mixology. Balanced to Delicious, Dale DeGraff. Thank you.
This song, is this thing on?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, man. You know, we're in the beautiful Bay Area. You know what I'm saying? The homegirl just holding it down over here. You know, just keeping it real solid, not salad. You feel me? You feel me? Let me take all in here, how we really mobbing on shit.
Flex. You got cereal money, what's that? Some little checks. What's that? I'm not mesh from it, just a little neck. Just a little
crazy. That's nuts. That's it.
Y'all fuck with music.
Yeah.
I fuck with that Mercy.
Sheesh. Sheesh.
That's hard.
Cherish these nights like these.
Yeah, man.
Cherish these.
Easy is easy. You ain't knowing, but believe me.
You call in the album, these things happen too. It's coming back around.